Hello guys, and welcome back. Yes, yesterday, the previous video, I was making these gratings. So now, in today's video, I'm going to make the gratings for these cargo holes, also here. I don't know if it's cargo holes or and something else, but definitely are holes over here. And if I have the time, I will make also the gratings for here. So let me place the camera on a tripod, gather my material, and I'll get back to you. And I have my materials. This is the frame for these gratings. It's 4x4, it's separately. But before making any work on the frame, also here I have cannonballs. I don't know if they're going to be enough. If they're not, I'm going to show you how you can get new and many more. One thing that I wanted to tell you from yesterday is these gratings are the best quality I've ever seen. Even though Artesan Latina had very good quality, top quality of materials, their gratings had a small problem. In each and every piece, the center piece, the center ear, tooth, call it whatever you like, was bigger, more, it had more width than the others. So when you had to use more than the center, let's say that this one must have 13, let's say you wanted to use 8, the center piece was bigger, so in each grating you wouldn't have vertical lines. In a point you would have a small curve, so that was visible and noticeable. That was in Artesan Latinas, but here we're talking about top quality. So let's make the first one, guys. I'm seeing here in the plans that I have 7x10 the ears, the teeth, call them whatever you like. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 teeth here and 10 teeth here. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8x10 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 11x7. 8x10 and 11x7. Exactly like before, we need to have frame, so we cut the last one. This is 10. I will keep this because maybe I will need to make some smaller, but I doubt it, but okay, you never know. And also a 7 one. This is a 7. Let's see. We cannot have a second 7 from this. So let me cut them and I'll get back to you. Let's assemble the first one. The first one is ready. So let me make the other one, sand them down, and I'll get back to you. I have them, guys, already sanded. We'll do some more sanding later. Now, what I have to do is place the vertical pieces first. It's easy, just have to mark one. I need four. Doesn't matter if it's a bit more every piece, we will sand it down less, it's the problem. Now remember, guys, that this piece is 4 millimeters, 4x4. This side is 3, so you have to glue it on the top. You have to glue it like this. Underneath, it's going to have a gap, but at the top, it's going to be flat. That's the idea. To make sure that it's going to be flat, this is the easiest way. Also move it a little, because if cyanoacrylic glue gets over to a surface, it will glue on the bench. Let this dry and let's make another one. you can see that underneath there is a gap, but on the top it's flat. Let me sand them on the sides and I'll get back to you to do the rest of the frame. Everything is sanded. Now I have to cut two pieces of, let me see, 12.1 centimeters. So I need two pieces at 12.1. Okay guys, I just made a mistake. These pieces supposed to be over here, so I have to unglue them. Like I said, wood can forgive mistakes. Now it's going to be hard. So let me unglue the other ones, make them correctly, and I'll get back to you. So, got them, let's glue them. Now, let's sand. It's not ready yet. So, give me a moment to get my power drill and I'll get back to you. Now, we have to open some holes for the cannonballs. The drill tip that you need for the hole is 2.5 millimeters, so you have to leave some space between them. So the first hole is going to be made around here, and each hole would be 5 millimeters apart, each hole's center. Now guys, before using the power drill, I must make some marks on the wood to guide the drill tip. That's not hard. I use this pointy file, some pressure, and the job is done. Let me do that in the entire surface and I'll get back to you. Let's drill. You're not going to be able to see, guys, but I must be able to see. I'm not drilling all the way, as you can see. Let me focus. Just a little, enough to make the cannonball stand there. So I will do that in the entire surface and I'll get back to you to mount the cannonballs. I have placed some wood putty here at the joints to make it even. As you can see, I've made all the holes. Now all I have to do is place the cannonballs. And just a little tip. If it happens to run out of cannonballs, something that it's very common in every model that I made, always there was just enough or just less than what you needed. The last model of Okre was okay, the Santisma Trinidad. In this one I don't know, I haven't placed any yet, but if it happens to run out of cannonballs, it's easy. This is a buckshot slug. This is the number you need. It's 3¾. Don't know what the other means. It's -1¼-6. Okay, that's the number. It's this is by Remington. The buckshots that this slug has inside have the exact same I forgot the word size, that has exact same size that you need. So let the wood putty dry, sand it a little, and I'll get back to you to mount the cannonballs. Everything is beautiful. Sanded again the surface. So let's place some cannonballs. Here are the cannonballs. Here's my glue. So guys, it's done. As you can see, it looks beautiful. With some varnish, it look even better. So now let's place it to its final position. To make it straight, you have guidelines from the planks of the deck. All you have to do is center the holes. Done. Looks beautiful. And underneath we have the LEDs, so when the lights are on, it will look even better. I will do a test run later, but now we'll have to make this one. Now let's glue, guys. make it even, because it isn't, as you can see, and I'll get back to you. I have also cut the side pieces, so let's glue. Now I have to cut this excess, do some sanding, also make the holes again, place the cannonballs, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And done. This is it, guys. All the gratings are in place. As you can see, she looks fantastic. Not a very hard work to make the gratings, just time consuming, but everything is done. And for the next step, we're going to make some ladders and some rails for the deck. So that's it for the gratings, guys. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon with the next step.